Okay, I want to talk a little bit about exam two. There is a list of course objectives, things that you should be able to do in kind of English written, and then there is also a list of review problems. Okay, so exam two covers all of chapter two. For exam 2, you should be able to find the derivative using the limit definition. That's f prime of x is equal to the limit as h goes to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x, all divided by h. We tested this on the first exam. It absolutely will be tested on the second exam. So you should be able to do this. You also won't get any credit on that problem unless you use the limit definition, and this is the key word that you're looking for on the exam to see what you need to do and where you need to apply this. Okay, the other thing, there will be just a series of problems where you calculate derivatives. We have done that over and over for different sections here, and we have used these rules, the power rule, that's for things like 8x to the 7th power, the constant rule, the constant multiplier rule, which also allows me to deal with this 8. The constant rule is just that if f of x is equal to some constant 5, then the derivative is 0, right? So the constant multiplier rule, the product rule, the quotient rule, and the chain rule and general power rule. Those are things you definitely need to put into your memory. Get that stuff memorized, write yourself note cards, write those rules out, especially this quotient rule. There will be likely about 10 to 20 of you who will get that wrong on the exam, just the basic, not even applying it, but just the basic what it is. So you can make sure that you're not missing out on those little bits of points that can add up to a lot by just getting this memorization stuff down, okay? So we also did higher order derivatives, the first, second, and third derivatives. That's here. Find the derivative of a function defined implicitly. We just did that. That's section 2.5. And you can tell there's no f of x equal to in those problems or y equal to in those problems. The y is somewhere floating around, right? It looks something like that, where these x's and y's are mixed up. These functions are defined implicitly, and that's the material that we covered in 2.5. Okay. The other, I think, kind of the rest of this might be interpretation. Let's look and make sure I think I tried to do that. Find where the derivative is equal to 0. You just find the derivative f prime of x, and then you set it equal to 0, right, and solve for x. We did that at various points throughout this this chapter, and that's a leading question into chapter 3. Using these rules, all those product rule, quotient rule, chain rule above, find the instantaneous rate of change. This interpretation of the derivative hasn't changed, even though we've been studying these shortcut methods. So it's still related back to the instantaneous rate of change. And the next objective, using the rules above, find the slope and equation of the tangent line. That is also true, even though we're still doing these shortcut methods and not using the limit definition. So you should be able to do those based on what we've seen. And you don't have to use the limit definition to find now the slope of the tangent line. You can use, say, the product rule or this general power rule or whatever to find this derivative. Okay? Interpret the first derivative in applied situations. That will come into play. I have a list of about 7 or 8 word problems at the end of the review that I typed up. And all of those just kind of ask you to interpret what's happening and what the derivative tells you about the function. Same thing for marginal analysis. This is where we looked at this idea that f prime of x is about approximately when h is small, this, right? So, and then when H is 1, I'm looking at F prime approximating this difference right here. So you'll see problems that kind of ask you, like, what's happening between year 9 and 10? That's a 1 year difference between these, and you're talking about using the derivative and marginal analysis to analyze that problem or to estimate that change. Okay? So all of the word problems that I gave you in the review list of problems, you need to be using the derivative to answer those problems. Otherwise, you won't receive credit on the exam. Okay? So it's about understanding how the derivative is related to how this function is changing. And then finally, from again, section 2.5, solving related rate problems. Okay? So that's it. This list of items is much shorter than the first exam, but the information is definitely packed in there. It will be, again, a doable exam, but you should expect to see some difficult problems on the exam, just like we saw in class. So please study, and let me know if you have any questions.